Now, the historian architecture itself, what you see here is in the middle specifically is your historian server. And in the middle where we have things called data stores and historian archives, which is really the way you group your data as it's coming from your different data sources. Proficy Historian can collect data using things called collectors. So we have collectors and different versions of collectors that can be configured, as you see here, OPC UA collector that can collect SCADA data. You can also use IGS or MQTT to collect data from your PLCs or other systems you have. Remote assets too, can data maybe coming from different oil wells, from rigs, and coming from different remote assets also. We have collectors that can be configured to collect that data. As that data is pushed into the historian data store and the historian archives, we then make this data readily available to the clients that you see on the right here. So up here are the various options you have for GE Vernova Proficy clients that you can connect the data to. So you can send, after being stored in historian, you can send your data to SCADA systems. You can use Operations Hub to build visuals using this data. Proficy C sends for analytics as well. We have an inbuilt Excel add-in that you can use Excel itself to actually manage your historian. So you can create custom reports using the Excel add-in. And like I said, for other systems as well, there are various options available to export and utilize your data. So if there are, for your ignition system, you have the SCADA itself, right? And then you have, and maybe the ignition historian as well. We can get data from those two different sources as well and store it within our Proficy Historian. Now, to distribute your data to any of those systems, right? These are the options available to you. It's just depending on where you want to make use of that data. If you want to use the data for visualization purposes, we have Operations Hub that will be the exporting interface you use. If you don't need to send it, of course, back to your ignition SCADA in this sense, you don't need to do that. We offer like an Excel, like Proficy Historian Excel add-in where once you do and include this add-in to your regular Microsoft Excel, you'll be able to query your historian data through that Excel add-in directly, build the reports, get CSV files instantly using this add-in. And then, of course, I'll touch more on Operations Hub. That's the first part of the demo I'm actually going to show before going to our historian server. Okay, really quick to show you the configuration and implementation options you have available to you. You can have Proficy Historian servers sitting on your each individual terminal you have available that is then consolidating that data locally on at those terminals. But then you can now have that data rolling up as well to a cloud enterprise version that's really centralizing your data across the entire enterprise, where the local sites and terminals have access to their data. But then you also, at a higher level view, have access to the entire portfolio. Now, if you do not need the local level to have access to that data, you can easily just use the collectors, like I mentioned, to collect the data from those terminals from the site and roll it up directly to the Historian Enterprise server.
Yeah, this is Brian, the PM for Historian. I think the beauty of the architecture that Abose is showing is you can choose either a cloud-based Proficy Historian or a Windows on-prem version, and you get the same feature set in both. So if you're looking to sort of get out of managing on-site infrastructure and want to leverage sort of the scalability in cloud, and like you see there on the right-hand side of the slide, the zero downtime upgrades, you're going to get more Historian for your money, basically, when you look at cloud, because it gives you the zero downtime upgrades. And then the way that the cloud handles all of your data, it replicates it into multiple what they call availability zones. And so you get redundancy by default with cloud. So there's a few benefits, but you get the same underlying historian architecture that Abose showed on a previous slide, whether you choose on-prem or cloud. So you win either way. We
They're
have
all
both,
option.
yeah, we have collector compression. So bringing the data in, it can be compressed, and then it can be compressed again when it gets to the archive. Yep. And we have many customers that are doing exactly that and then running different metrics off of data that they've kept in their historian essentially as long as I've been alive. So it's a very efficient system, and data that you've stored decades ago has the same fidelity as something that you may have brought in 10 milliseconds ago. So it's really very efficient, and it works both ways on cloud and on-prem.
What Brian was explaining, so we have collector compression and archive compression available. Before we go on to the demo, just to show you what that Excel add-in looks like in here, since we may not be able to go with that, let me show you. So basically, like I mentioned, we have the Excel add-in that's available to you that you can use to, like, as if you're within the historian configuration hub tool, you can use it to query your data as you want, specifically query the time zones and query specific time ranges that you want to query as well, and filter your data as needed to build specific tailored reports like you see on here. So you have the specific tags you're pulling in here. You have the specific range of data as well available to you using the Excel add-in. Yeah, so if you have like a regular CSV file, which let me switch, like a CSV file, Excel file, right? You can import that directly into Historian. So this is the Historian tag database that you have available by simply using the import, and you can export your data too directly from here as CSV files as well. But you can import the data if you have a specific CSV file to import. You can choose the selected file you want to import as well. So in here, where we are currently are at now is what we call Configuration Hub. And this is where, like I said, you manage all of your Proficy components. So we have Operations Hub, we have our Historian, our other Proficy clients like SCADA and so on are available, as well as your security. And what specifically I've selected on here is the Operations Hub, where you use to build your different screens and visualizations. And this is the Northwest Utility app that you see that's made available. And I'm going to launch this app now, just so we walk through it briefly. Come back in there. Perfect. So now this is really like a demo application that we've built within the business consultant team. And we have many applications similarly like this, just to show what is possible, what you're able to configure within Operations Hub. So we've built this dashboard, an enterprise level dashboard to monitor utilities across the Northwest, right? Different wind turbines you're seeing here, transmission, transformer stations, and also generation stations. Coming simply into like our transformer, one substation here, we can see that we've used different display widgets here to show data coming from different assets relating to this transformer. So you can build different displays showing current voltage. You can really configure and name this as you want. You're not restricted to just this dashboard layout that I'm currently showing. You can manage and configure the specific location, the text sizes, and everything within this dashboard. And all you have to do is you drag and drop within Operations Hub and workspace interface and make the connection to your Historian database. Similarly, we have other screens that we've created like this to show what's possible. So in this screen right now, we're using gauge widgets. We have charts that should be showing any second from now. And then we have other forms of gauges that are also showing and displaying the data for us. Now you can come in here, of course, and also even get this widgets right now as a PNG file or PDF. For here, this page right now, you can configure the specific selection using this calendar date time picker here to select the time range that's populating for all these displays. You can use and make buttons for you to navigate through the entire application as needed. So we have another different screen selection here that we've created, where we're monitoring all the readings for this specific wind turbine asset. All the sensor readings are on here. We have different charts also showing. And alarm and event trend cards can even be created to connect to your SCADA alarm and events data. So operators can also monitor those alarms as they populate for each asset. For you, like within Historian, you're able to trend and view things like your last 10 values, right? But we also have this additional trending tool here that you mentioned is important too, where you can create favorite pages and favorite really tags that matter to specific operators. And you can really cycle through your selection. As you see within the team, we've created a lot of different pages that we use for our demos. And we've grouped them into different organizing options here. So like just clicking on one of the selections, that trend card easily populates for us. So you can immediately do trend analysis on important assets where different operators can select and save assets to the favorite organizer that they can always click on whenever they want to refer to. And this is pre-configured already and you can save it. But if you want to do additional configuration, you have the selection here for you to make those configurations. So if you want to view the assets specifically live data coming from this asset, if you want to do it historically by different duration times, you can also do that and you hit apply and it will change real quick for us right now. You can hit apply again to change it. Even specifically, if you want to pull right now, these are all the different assets, Historian tags that we're basically looking at from our gas turbine. We can immediately through here, clean this up some more if we want to apply. You can even add more tags directly from your Historian database here. Come to Proficy Historian, this. You have all your Historian tags. You can search for specific tags that you know you want to pull. These are other selections that have already been made. You can add some more to that selection and it's been added and can close it and just hit save. And immediately that's shown. If you want to create limits, different configurations are available to you for you to manage your trend card within Operations Hub once you've done and created that. You can also use our Delta tool if you're looking to find the difference between two different points. You have that available within here. And you have different view options too for this trend cards. A Y-stacked axis. That'll be available. A tabular view if you want to view the actual table of all the trends is available to you within this trend analysis tool. Operations Hub comes with your Historian license already to build and configure at least that trend analysis page that I just showed you. If you want to configure more pages, we can discuss how many pages you want to configure and all that, but at least you get that trend analysis with your license. And it comes included in a page like this where we have trend analysis. Just I show you what that page looks like. So you get, this is your workbench area for Operations Hub, how you build pages like this that you're seeing, right? So this is that trend analysis. So this is the specific card you use. We have this widget that available here that you can drag and drop different types of widget depending on the display you want to create. So we have the line charts here that are showing these charts available to you. You have the display charts and that I also showed as well. All you need to do is drag and drop in this work area here and then come to your data and link it to your Historian data. Select your hist, look for whatever asset you want to drag and drop and it shows you've made your connection available. Once I hit save and launch the page, I have the new, I've configured the page immediately right now. So now that we've seen the visualization portion, basically how you build those screens, how you get it to this stage now, I would walk back and show the Historian section because how do you configure a Historian database to have all the data pulling in from and the right different on-site Historian in your situation. Let me just close this. Yes, this is fine. Now, still within Configuration Hub here, easily after selection here, we have our Historian site one. Here, this would be your enterprise historian, and you have the ability to configure and manage your entire historian server. So you can do things like manage your historian server right here. We have this one demo VM server. You can see all the different information relating to that server, like your license count, different information relating to how many collectors we've configured, sold out tags on this specific server, as well as data stores and clients. As you go on, you can also configure and manage your different data stores. In your situation, this is really important because you're pulling data from different terminal sites. So how you would probably configure this data store is to have a data store dedicated for each site. So you could have terminal one data store, terminal two data store. And that way, when you configure your archives, you know the data coming into the archives for these data stores and how they are related to each specific terminal as you want. Now you can query, of course, on the tag face level here. If you're querying a specific tag, it doesn't matter what archive is sitting, it's going to pull the information for you. But at least for management level information, you may want to configure this as needed so you can export the data for each specific data store as you need. But also, as you select and you click in the middle here, you can see additional extra details for each data store here. You know, things like your security, the archive specifically, how the archives can be created. You can, right now, we've configured it to create a new archive to create every 7 days, but you can definitely configure this by hours or by size, like 500 megabytes or another different size as needed. And then, of course, your archives here showing you that collection interval that we've decided and creation interval that we've decided for these archive files. You have an array of collector options available for you here, and you can configure as many collectors as you want. Really, I think Jason would correct me if I'm wrong, but your collectors are not licensed. All that's really in your license is your tags. You license how many tags you need. You can configure whatever collector you need to integrate with that data source you have available. And then importantly, of course, once you have that done, you can now collect your tags from those data sources, and you can see a stream of those tags available within Historian. So you filter for specific tags you want to look for and focus on. And we already quickly mentioned the compression capabilities on the collector and archive levels. And as well, you can do scaling. You have a host of options here available for you to configure your tags as well. Now, we already went through the trend analysis capabilities within Operations Hub, but within Historian too, you can do some analysis, immediate analysis, where you can view and trend like the last 10 values of specific data points. Let me use a different one. In here, in our tag querying, I'm going to come to saved queries because I have specific tags that I like to show. So in here, you can immediately also do some trend analysis and capabilities within Historian. So right here, I'm viewing, and this is saved where these are important to me. So the same function as the in Operations Hub, I'm able to configure within Historian where I've saved these different tags as important to me. I can always come and pull this up to check and do immediate troubleshooting on any of these tags as needed. You can see the table as well of those values to see if they are writing appropriately and if they're good quality values.